Recent research has shown that people who have contracted SARS-CoV-2 have developed antibodies that can react to the coronavirus. Some researchers and doctors have started using plasma from those who recovered from COVID-19 to treat new patients who are critically ill. Onmanorama spoke to Dr. Mahesh B, the head of critical care medicine at Aster MIMS in Calicut, to learn more about this approach.
We treat patients who is affected with some infectious disease like virus or bacteria. Mm-hmm. So we treat those patients with already made or ready-made antibodies. So we have got antibodies in the body, which basically our body will make antibodies against the infectious agent. So that's a normal process.
Okay.
So what happens is it takes some time for the antibodies to develop.
Plasma therapy is not new. German physiologist Emil von Behring won the Nobel Prize in 1901 for using it to treat diphtheria. It was also used during the Spanish flu in 1918. Now, plasma is a component of blood. The blood of people who have recovered from COVID-19 contains antibodies. Antibodies are molecules that fight the viruses that cause the disease. Doctors administer it to people whose bodies are currently fighting COVID-19. Now, to be a plasma donor, one has to recover from COVID-19. The plasma can be taken 14 days after a person tests negative twice for coronavirus. The person should not have any other blood-borne diseases like HIV, hepatitis B, and other diseases. Age is also a factor, as young and healthy individuals are preferred. Among women donors, right now, doctors prefer those who have never been pregnant. But yes, there is a question of efficiency and safety in this kind of therapy. Even though the therapy looks helpful so far, we cannot ignore the risks inherent to the transfusion of blood or blood components. It is also not confirmed at what particular stage a patient must be given this therapy.
So COVID is a virus which affects the lung.
Yeah.
So when you're giving plasma, so it's just not plasma, platelets, blood products, all these things, basically what it does is it can cause something called transfusion-related lung injury.
Okay.
So transfusion-associated lung injury is called TRALI. And this TRALI is quite common in sick patients, especially when they develop a TRALI on top of severe bad COVID pneumonia. That is very, very dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
So I cannot say that it is safe.
Kerala recently got the first plasma bank at the Manjeri Medical College Hospital in Malappuram, and many persons have donated their plasma across the country. The doctor, however, felt that depending on plasma therapy alone might not help us in the future. But he asserted that the therapy, though experimental, so far has been helpful enough. The plasma therapy has been hyped too much that people have already started taking this as a proven cure. When we deal with a pandemic, healthcare facilities are overwhelmed and we find it difficult to find the right donor for patients. The therapy is also expensive and time-consuming.
I think it is hyped because mm-hmm. I think still there is not enough evidence. There,
okay.
It might be useful. I'm not saying it is not useful.
Yeah,
it
yeah.
might be useful, but I think we don't have enough studies. Such a labor-intensive job to mm-hmm. treat a pandemic is, you know, that doesn't make sense, because you are going to deal with 100,000, 200,000 people with this disease, and how much of plasma can you get? At the moment, it's still hyped.
Yeah.
I don't think it is a plasma therapy is the answer for everything.
Now, going forward, doctors could use this therapy alongside other options as they gradually become available. What we need now is more studies and a wait for the right vaccine.